In this video, we're going to take a look at the creation of circular patterns using the axis option of the pattern tool in Creo Parametric. Here you can see that I have a circular extrusion and then a smaller circular extrusion on top of that. I would like to create a pattern of this smaller circular feature around the shape. To do so, I'll begin by selecting the feature. I'll do that over here in my model tree. Then I will select the pattern tool. Next, I'm going to adjust the type and select axis. If I take a look at the status bar or the little message that popped up next to my mouse, I can see that I need to define the pattern center. I should select a datum axis. I'll go ahead and select the axis here. Then in my ribbon, I can specify how many of these items I want. So let's say I want 8 of them. And I can decide the angle between them. If I'm not really sure of the angle between them, I can instead choose the angular extent. Then it will fill 360 degrees with the 8 members. I can go ahead and click OK, and I can see the end result there. What if I only wanted half a circle? Well, then I'll go back and edit the definition, and then I'll ask it to fill 180 degrees instead. There you can see from the original, it is going counterclockwise. If I want to force it to clockwise, then I'll click the flip button, and I can see that it's going to create them all on one side of the part now. I'm going to edit this one more time and set it back to 360 degrees. And also take a look at the option to create multiple rows. So let's say I wanted 2 rows of these, and then I can specify the distance between them. So let's say I want 1/2 inch between them. As we can see, that space is not nearly enough and it's going the other direction. So let's say I wanted 2 inches of space between them, but I'm going to flip those by making this a -2 inches. And now you can see they're going to go in from there. Now you can see I have 2 circular rows of these features. Once again, if I want to return it back to the original, I can edit the definition and just set it back to 1 row here. Let's say that I wanted a hole inside each one of these features. So I'm going to add a hole to my original. I'll just select the face, hold control, select the axis, specify a diameter, and let's say I want it to go through all. I now want to create one of these holes on each of these raised features. I could do another axis pattern. The problem is though, I would rather it reference the existing pattern. So that way, if the existing pattern changes, my holes update. I'll select my hole and select the pattern tool. Fortunately, Creo is pretty smart. It recognizes that there is already a pattern there and it chose the reference option for me automatically. Of course, I could choose that manually if for some reason it did not. I'll go ahead and click OK, and you can see the set of holes now match the feature pattern. I'll go and modify the original pattern, and let's say that I instead want 9 members. I'll go ahead and click OK, and I can see that the holes update to match the new quantity. Finally, if there are any copies that I do not actually want in my final model, I can simply remove those while creating the feature. Once again, I'll edit the feature, and let's say that I don't want the feature over here. I'm going to go ahead and click the dot to remove it. And because the hole pattern was based upon that feature pattern, you can see that both the hole and the feature are now gone from this model. It's very easy to think about circular features when we're creating an axis pattern, but this also works on rectangular features as well. Here you can see that I have an extrusion based on a square, so each side is the same, and I have a recessed feature on one side. I would like to duplicate that on all the other sides. I'll do this by patterning it around an axis. I'll select this cut feature, then select my pattern tool. I'll change my type to axis. And while I don't have an axis drawn there, I can actually pick my Y axis here. Then I can specify how many I want. So I want 4 of them with 90 degrees between them. I'll go ahead and click OK. And you can see that I really quickly generated that same feature cutout on all 4 sides using the pattern. Once again, if maybe I didn't want it on one of the sides, then I could edit the feature pattern and remove that dot. And now I can see that that item has been added to the other 3 surfaces. That concludes this look at circular axis patterns in Creo Parametric.